Hello folks, welcome into the ITLS Academy. Myself, Dr. Himani, PhD in Tissue Engineering and Regenerative Medicines. Today our lecture on animal cloning applications and issues. So let's start with the outline of this lecture. In this lecture, we will cover what is animal cloning, how cloning works, types of clonings, advantages and disadvantages of the cloning of animals, issues related to clonings, current scenario of the cloning and future of the animal cloning. So let's start with the what is cloning. Clones like identical twins are exact genetic copy of each other. The difference is that twins turn up without scientists being involved and are born at the same time. But clones are created in the lab and can be born year apart. Already scientists have cloned 11 kind of animals including sheep, cow, pigs, mice and horses. Cloning animals is a reliable way to reproducing superior livestock genetics and ensuring herds are maintained at the highest quality possible. It is important to remember that cloning does not manipulate the animal's genetics makeup nor changes an animal DNA. It is simply another form of assisted reproduction. Cloning allow livestock breeders to create an exact genetic copy of existing animal, essentially an identical twins. Clone are superior breeding animal used to produce healthier offsprings. So here is some example of animal cloning. First example is Dolly. Dolly was the female domestic sheep and the first mammal cloned from an adult somatic cells using the process of nuclear transfer. And next example is Herman is a bull. First transgenic mammal, Herman the bull was the first genetically modified or transgenic mammals in the world. And next example is Super Mouse. First transgenic animal was a Super Mouse created by the Ralph Brittas and Richard Palmer in 1982. It was created by inserting a human growth hormone gene in mouse genome. The offspring was much larger than the parents. Now, how cloning works. To understand how cloning works, it helps to know how animals normally reproduce. All animals, including people, have a set of structures in each cell called chromosomes. Chromosomes contain genes. Genes are made of molecules known as DNA. DNA holds all information necessary to keep cell and the body working. Humans have 23 pairs of chromosomes. When two animals mate, each offspring gets one set of chromosomes from its mother and one from its father. The particular combination of genes that you happen to get determine a lot of things about you, such as the color of your eyes, nose, structures, body, skin color, so many things. Parents have no control over which genes they give to their kids. Only identical twins are born with the exactly the same combination of genes. The goal of cloning is to take control of the reproductive process. You are taking out all the randomness. by selecting a specific combination of genes to get what you want. So now, what is the exact definition of animal cloning? Cloning allows livestock breeders to create an exact genetic copy of existing animal, essentially an identical twins. Clones are superior breeding animals used to produce healthier offsprings. Or in the other word, we can say cloning have the same phenotype, have the same genotype and same identical copies of an individual. Now, types of cloning. Here is the three types of cloning is present. First one is gene or DNA cloning. It's duplication of strings of DNA containing genes in a host bacterium. Next one is the molecular clones. Molecular clones is copy of a cell are made resulting in a cell line. And next one is the embryonic twinning clones. Embryos which has already been formed sexually is split into two identical halves. So these are the three types of the clones. Now, more useful techniques, only these two techniques are more useful in cloning. First one is the embryo splitting and next one is the nuclear transfer. So first, let's discuss about the embryo splitting. Here, embryo splitting is the things. In this formation, you can see in this picture, here is the embryo and embryo is split to form into two halves embryos. First one half part is this and the next second half part is this. And then this half embryos is transferred to an untreated surrogate mother and then this surrogacy or we can say pregnancy is monitored by the ultrasound and then after some time sheep give birth to the identical twins. So this card is the cloning by the embryo splitting. So in this embryo splitting, which parameter used? First one, the egg collector. Second one, the fertilized by in vitro fertilization, it called IVF. And next one is the embryo is grown to 8 to 16 cells. Cells are separated. Separated cells grown into the separate embryos. Embryos transplanted into surrogate mother. Here you can see here. In this is the surrogate mother and may be used to clone any mammalian embryos including humans. So this is the process of embryo splitting. Next we will discuss about the nuclear transfer. In this nuclear transfer you can see here is the tissue of cell donor. And this is the donor supply unfertilized egg. And in this step, you can see this. In this step, the cells from animal to be cloned are maintained in the lab so they do not grow or divide. Nuclear is removed in this process. And here you can see this, the donor supplied unfertilized egg, this is the egg cells which from this animals and this egg cells, the nuclear is removed from the cells, and this nuclear fusion with the embryo egg after electronic current apply. So you can see here, this is the nucleus is removed from this cells, and here the again nucleus is also removed from the cells, and this is the process. In this process, the electronic current applied for the fusion. So after fusion, you can see here the reconstructed embryo grows for 7 to 16 days, and then the embryo is implanted into the surrogate mother. And after the implantation of in the surrogate mother, the cloned animal is born and with exact DNA as the tissue cell donor. So in this procedure, nuclear transfer, some parameters are used. First one is the first donate in this 1986 nuclear transfer, and second was the it is the very difficult process. Third one is the nucleus is removed from an egg, and nucleated eggs are fused with the other cells. Embryos are transplanted in a surrogate mother, and in 1997, Dolly the sheep was the first mammalian clone from an adult donor cell. Now you can understand by these pictures different stages of nuclear transfer cloning method. In the first step, you can see here they include division for cloning. First one stage is the cell collected from a sheep under, and second phase, the nucleus is removed from the unfertilized egg or second sheep. In the third phase, under cells nucleus is inserted into an egg with no nucleus. And stage 4, the insertion is the successful. You can see here this insertion is the successful. In the stage 5, electrical charges is supplied. This is the electrical charges is the supply. And stage 6, after the electrical charges, the cell being too divided. You can see here this cell is being too divided. In this picture, you can see how Dolly was created. So in first picture, you can see cells taken from the under for a film desert yule are placed in a culture with very low concentration of the nutrients. Thus, the cells stop dividing and switch off their active genes. In the second picture, you can see, meanwhile, an unfertilized egg cells is taken from a Scott blackface eel. This nucleus with the DNA is shoved out, leaving an empty egg cells containing all the cellular machinery necessary to produce an embryo. And in the third stage, the two cells are placed next to each other, and electrical fusion causes them to fuse together like soap bubble. You can see here, this look like a soap bubble. A second pulse mimics the burst of the energy at the natural fertilization jump starting cell division. Here is the after fusion, cell division is the started. And in the fourth stage, after about 6 days, the resulting embryo is implanted in the uterus of another blackface eel. And in the last picture and fifth stage, after gestation, period, the pregnant blackfish eel give birth to a baby Finn Dorset lamb named Dolly that is genetically identical to the original donor. So now we will discuss about the advantage and disadvantage of the cloning. First, let's see some applications of the cloning. You can see first application to produce desired individuals. Second application of the cloning is to rapid propagate desired individuals. And third application is to produce genetic target genes, different organs. Next application is clone of endangered species, and next one is the clone animal is for testing new drugs and treatments, and next application is to produce desired individual for research purpose. Now we will discuss advantages of cloning animals. First we will discuss is animal cloning create desirable traits in each species. It is an opportunity to create specific traits in an animal that are desired for some reason. We might use animal cloning to create dairy cows that offer more milk. We might clone chickens to improve egg production. Pig could be cloned to produce more meat for the butt chucking. So this is the advantage of animal cloning, create desirable traits in each species. Next we will discuss about the we can introduce specific outcomes through animal cloning. There is a protein which is called antithrombin that circulate in the blood. If you don't have enough of it, then your risk of developing a blood clot is higher. When clots form, they can lead to stroke and heart attacks or worse. Through the process of animal cloning, goats have been bred in such a way that they now produce this protein on their own. We can then clone these animals to produce more of these medicines, which create a supply that is theoretically endless. Now we will discuss about the third point. It is a chances to keep memories alive. One of the fastest growing segments of the animal cloning industries involve dogs and cats. Pets are often integrated as full-fledged members of our family. Losing them is one of the most painful experiences that we endure. With the cloning process, there is an opportunity to provide continuity even during moments of the grief. Next point is, it is currently believed to be safe to eat cloned animals. The Food and Drug Administration is the United States ruled in 2008 that it was safe to eat meat and consume dairy products from cloned animals. They made their ruling for livestock animals such as goat, pig and cows. That makes it possible for food producers to research cloning process that could improve human nutrition. Next advantage we will discuss, animal cloning provide additional research benefit. As we learn how to clone animals successfully, we could use those techniques to learn how to clone organs for human transplant. We might be able to clone specific cells that offer medical benefits. It has sparked an advancement in team stem cell research that include deriving these cells from the adults. Next, we will discuss advantage of it could provide a process to restore lost species to the planet. When looking at the history of our planet, we know that at least 1.9 million different animal species have gone existing. Thanks to the science behind animal cloning, the preserved DNA of existing animal could be artificially brought to term as an embryo to restore their progenies. And next we will discuss about the seventh topic is the 7 points is the animal cloning is a process which could lead to human cloning. So, one of the most problematic illness that human battle each season in influenza. Flu epidemic have killed millions of people in the past. Especially when a new strain of the virus begin to circulate through the population. About 1 in 5 people will get sick with it each year, even with the availability of the annual vaccines to prevent it. The flu virus originate in birds, pigs, and other animal species. Our animal cloning process could work to stop its development by creating more resiliency against its activity when it forms. It's an opportunity to stop the adverse impact of disease before it even gets a chance to begin. And next, cloning technology will always have an ethical argument against its use. So we will discuss about in the next drawback of the clones. Now here is some drawback of the clones. First is it's a very expensive. Second one is it's a time consuming. Next is the cell mutation may occur. Next drawback is the organ rejection because of cell mutation. And next drawback is the clones do not always look identical. And other disadvantages, same clones cannot survive. Now let's discuss about the disadvantage of the cloning. First we will discuss about the animal cloning is an expensive process. The current cost to clone an animal which is used for livestock is about $20,000 per instance. You could ask someone to clone your cat for you if you have $20,000 to invest. At the moment, however, it is an opportunity which is still available to only a selected few people. Next will is from a reproduction standpoint, every other method is better than cloning. Animal cloning is the least reliable method of reproduction right now. Numerous defects occur during the cloning process that are potentially fatal to the offspring. Even if you were to front the $20,000 to clone your favorite cow, there is a 25% that the animal will suffer from high drops which cause edema. About 6% of cow are oversized which may threaten the life of the mother. Next disadvantage is even with modern science, animal cloning is usually unsuccessful. Animal cloning is often unsuccessful even when everything goes right during the process. Only 5% of cloning attempts are ever successful. Cloning increases the risk of birth defect development, sensory impairment, and disease susceptibility. Next disadvantage is cloning animal could result in sterility issues. This disadvantage is another issue that is coming to a resolution in the near future, but it still impacts the current generation of animal clones. When scientists create a clone, then there is a higher risk that the animal will not have the capability to producing offspring. If that impairment does not exist, the risk factors stay higher than they do with natural reproduction for the next generation. Next disadvantage is successful cloning reduces genetic diversity for the species. We already know that happen when a lack of diversity occurs in the animal kingdom, when each animal of a species is genetically similar to one another. Then one viral mutation can create an extinction if a disease would affect the entire species for some reason, you would still have a 1% potential survival rate. With animal cloning, you would not even have that. Next disadvantage we will discuss about is the current process of animal cloning destroy numerous embryos. For the first successful clone animal, there were 277 clone embryos implanted. From that numbers, only 13 pregnancies were triggered. Those result in one successful birth, which would be Dolly. Only 17% of somatic cells nuclear transfer develop into embryo. In each series, only one or two animals are ever successfully born, with 18% of them dying at birth. Over half die within the first month. Next disadvantage is animal cloning is a process which could lead to human cloning. Although there have been claims of the successful human cloning attempts, there is no supported scientific evidence to suggest that a cloned human embryo has moved out of the world of fiction. Cloning humans is more difficult than other mammals because of where spindle proteins are located to the chromosomes. Removing the nucleus removes those proteins, which interferes with cell division. As technology improves, however, the science behind animal cloning could lead to human cloning, and the plethora of the moral and intellectual arguments which would come with it. Now, next disadvantage is cloning technology will always have an ethical argument against its use. The process of cloning could conflict with many of the long-standing social and religious values that people hold. In some way, it may even infringe upon the idea of having an individual identity. Although it may help with animal sterility issues, save species from extinctions and other unknown possible benefits, this debate will not go away. In short, we can compare what is the advantage and disadvantage of the cloning. First is advantages. We can make copies with the characteristic we want. Disadvantages, we reduce variant in species. Advantages, we can make many copies of the kind of animals we want quickly. And disadvantages, cloned animals have short life spans. Advantage, existing or endangered species can be repopulated through cloning. And disadvantage is, cloning is regarded as immoral by many people. Advantage, make it possible to produce a genetically identical copy of an individual for tissue or organ transplantation. And disadvantages, many even thousands of eggs may be required to generate one viable clone, a wasteful, expensive process. Now we will discuss about the issues related to cloning. First, we will discuss about the legal aspects. First legal aspects is animal testing, breeding for the unhealthy traits. Second legal aspects is violations of the constitutional rights. Third aspects is inclusion of animal protection in the constitutions. Now the ethical aspects. Association with the ethical consideration of the fellow creature states an ethical judgment of animal cloning. Different positions in the social debates and assessments of the animal cloning can be traced back to some extent to different fundamental values. Like, first one is having the right to have children no matter how they are created. Second ethical aspects is wondering if cloned kids may suffer from any social repercussion, if so, what? Third ethical aspects is some religious things cloning is a way of playing God. Next ethical aspects is it right to harvest organ from a clone? And next one is it justifiable to kill a human embryo for stem cell? Now we will discuss about the some facts related we will discuss about the some current scenario of the cloning. Cloning is a developing research field, and active efforts for the farm animal cloning are going on in more than 30 countries, including New Zealand and Australia, UK, other European countries, USA, and China, Iran, and India. Support is provided to scientists to explore cloning and utilize all its potential benefits. Now, what is the future of the cloning? Scientists have accelerated more into the world of animal cloning. Since Dolly, the first cloned mammal, was created, scientists have cloned many more of the mammalian species, such as horse, pigs, cow, and a big supply of rodents. For a few hundred years, scientists have tried to protect endangered species. So question is that, why not just clone them? Want to bring back the dinosaur? Clone them. The process of copying an animal could indeed do miracle. So scientists plan on rooting out the disease of the donor animal by using DNA transfer techniques. Using these techniques, they also plan on making better meat and food carrying by livestock and other animals such as pig and sheep. The fur will also be enhanced, and the same technique will be used to purify the protein in medicines and therefore help ones struggling with a moral disease. The risk of cloning are incredible. What if the cloning took were contaminated when they were used to fix the protein of medicine? A serious disease could start and the world would lose a big chunk of its population. So, in today's lecture, we have covered animal cloning applications and related to issues. If you have any query, then you can ask me by comments or by mail. You can follow us on Insta, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, WhatsApp and LinkedIn. So I would to say thank you for listening me. Hope you all enjoy this lecture. Thank you again.